All right, mate, so why do most people come to Cairns? Is it to get eaten by crocs? Maybe. Did you get stung by jellies? Well, of course, that's always a fun day. But now there's one attraction that Cairns has that brings out the crowds more than anything else, and that's the GBR, the Great Barrier Reef. Okay, so now we're doing it today. We're getting the GBR done, the main event for here. I got my stinger suit on. Look at that, nice. Of course, I got a shirt on too, because I'm not going to be a bloody Italian strutting around with a wiener hanging out in public. Only the eye ties can pull that off, mate. Now I've got to put on a shirt over the stinger until you get in the water. All right, let's go to the pier, mates. All right, mates, we're at the reef. We're not at the reef. We're at the harbour. We're going to pick up the boat to the reef. Because for all the people who don't know, the GBR is about 2 hours. It's about 2 hours from the coastline. So the GBR is way out there, the Great Barrier Reef. And I'm carrying 10 things here. Gonna leave the hotel key right in the car. Okay, GBR is about 2 hours off the reef. So the tours all end up being like a couple hours. All day really. A couple hours to get out there. And you gotta pay for bloody parking down here. So look at that. See that ticket? Got a bloody ticket booth? Come on, Cairns, you can give us a little free parking, can't you? Bloody bastards. What's that?
Really?
It's,
cool.
How was it called again?
I think they might be banyan trees.
Yeah, they're banyan trees, that's it, that's the name.
You know, the biggest tree in the world is a banyan tree, and it's in India.
Oh, they haven't chopped it down yet?
No.
Nah, if you're wondering what the harbour at Cairns looks like at 8 a.m, well, this is it. It's actually a bit of a hustle of activity here. Have a look. These are all the reefers. The reefer madness. It's reefer madness down here. Look at this, they got so many reef tours here in Cairns. It's like an airport. Bloody airport terminal in here. Finding the crew. The tours. I've never seen anything like this. This is big. Got different windows, like what car are you renting, what's going on? Don't know, mate. Oh my god, this marina is so busy. There's no doubt about what tours pay the bread and butter here. It's like 5,000 people out here at 8 a.m. on the marina. Crikey. We got to go down Finger A, which is where we are now. It's busier than a cruise terminal down here. All for the bloody reef tours. Crikey. I think we got the only sailing boat on this entire dock. Passions of Paradise. Some silly name like that. There it is. The Passions 2. The Passions 3. Fine vessel.
I believe this is called the puke boat.
Although no, there's a lot of land lovers. There's a lot of land lovers that call these things. Puke all over the place. I've never been on a boat before. It's so stinking hot already. Should have wet my stinger suit down. Ah, so yeah, the purpose of the stinger suit, it's not a wetsuit. Stinger suit just stops the deadly jellies from killing you in your spot when you're trying to enjoy the reef. Because it is Australia after all, everything kills you down here. But all right, on to the Passion. On to the Puke Express. Here we go, mates.
Good morning, how are we?
Morning. Yeah, you got the tickets there?
Hang on. Yep, that's you guys.
All right. Perfect. Not the Passions 1, not the Passions 2.
This is Passions 3.
Is it the best Passion?
No, that's the best shirt. I love it.
Oh, you like this shirt? Nice, nice. I bought this at a store like 15 years ago. They don't sell them anymore.
Mate, that is awesome.
We got our own. Oh, you got your own dress? Yeah, oh, good sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, how are we all feeling this morning?
Much better.
That's a
Let's try and keep that rolling throughout the day, eh?
We're at the Great Barrier Reef. Out in the middle of the ocean, the great. There's no land on the horizon as far as the eye can see. Nothing. Water's a little cold. Get in. Alright, we're here. Snorkeling the Great Barrier Reef. Here it is, I don't know what's going on. There's a million people in the water. Okay, let's take a look. Oh, that's pretty nice.
Good.
Reef! Bloody reef!
I've got my mouth thinking, of course.
Snorkeling on the Great Barrier Reef. I actually expect it to be a little more colourful, to be honest with you, mate. So what can you do with the weather and all that? The corals everywhere seem to be dying. But there is a lot of reef out here. This one's called, what do they call it? Point Break. So this reef spot is called, oh, you got lens of water on the lens? This reef spot's called Point Break. I'm expecting to see Keanu out here, but haven't found him yet. Just a bunch of bloody fish there. No Keanu at Point Break. And been running into people like crazy too. And you do these big group snorkels, you kind of got to get out of the way of everyone else. Get out of the group. Otherwise, nothing but flippers in your face, mate.
Hello, Mum.
What's your opinion of the roof?
Great Barrier Reef, so I am very excited. It's not as colorful as I expected, but I mean, I think reefs all over the world have been damaged. There's quite a bit of fish, though. I've seen schools of fish, all different kinds of fish, big fish. I tried to take some pictures. I'm not a photographer, so I don't know how that'll turn out, but we'll try. But everyone's going to lunch now, so we're going to do more. We're going to do actually more snorkeling. So we'll wait till everyone grabs the food and then we'll come in and we can have some peace and quiet. But I love it. I love it. We're here. The water is calm. The tide is out, so it's shallow.
And the water's about a perfect temperature, I'd say.
Oh, yeah.
I only saw one stinger so far. Only one stinger out here.
I haven't
seen any at all.
A little white one about that big. I don't know if it's one of the ones that'll kill you dead in your tracks. So I didn't get a photo of it. I just booked it out of there when I saw that jelly. Okay, so now we're at the second stop on the GBR Reef Tour. This place is called East Meets West. The Great Barrier Reef is actually like 1,000 miles long, 2,000 kilometers, something crazy. This is the second stop on our snorkel dive today. So let's see if it's a little better. Let's get in, mate. Meets west. This one's pretty cool actually. It's a lot shallower than the other one. And a lot of the coral is like right at the same level. So you can like float right over it. This one's pretty good actually. I'm impressed. That's the GBR. The bloody Great Barrier Reef. Australia's gift to the swimming community. It is very nice though. Alright, I don't know what else to say. See all the fish rolling around. It's still not super colourful. I know I can't remember where it was. I think I was snorkeling in Jamaica once. And that was super colourful snorkeling there. It's a little more, the colour's a little more subtle. It's a more grey than that. Still pretty nice though. Probably one of the best I've done in a while. But far away from the coastline. Can you see that over there? See the coastline way over there?
Yeah.
That's Cairns, mate. We're not there anymore.
I think it's great. I think it's really good snorkeling. The diversity of just wildlife here, the fish here, is quite extraordinary.
So this is, you come down for Christmas down under, this is what you'll be doing. You won't be shoveling driveways. You'll be snorkeling the GBR.
A
little better down under that way. Crikey, mate. All right, mate, so snorkeling's done for the day. We're headed back to Cairns. I got another 2-hour journey back to Cairns. But it's funny, like the second the stinger seats come off, the sun worshippers come out and everyone's right out on deck. It's the crazy. People really love the sun. I don't know how they do it. I've been in like 5 minutes, mate, but check this out. The sun worshippers are out in force. Ha ha. Crikey. And there's more sun worshippers on the bank. They're all over the ship now. The Aussie flag flowing gracefully. That one's red. Very unusual. Oh, there you go. There's probably more sun worshippers down here. Let's take a look. This is the engine room, more or less. All the tanks and stuff. People get done. Oh, wow. All right, let's look out front. And this cat's kind of cool. You can stand out on the bow and do your Leo thing. You know, everyone's got to do the Leo thing every once in a while. On the big ships, you can't go up front anymore. It's kind of a disappointment. But on this one, you can. All right, let's do it, mates. There we go, just like Leo. It's worth the day trip, just to sail on the boat. It's honestly, it's like 50% of the entire reef trip. It's just enjoying the ship. I love it. Do your Leo bit, look at that water. There's some up there.
I don't know how the Kappa can concentrate.
I think that goes without saying, mate. Quite a sight up there on the bow. I think the captain must have her on autopilot. I should certainly can keep my eyes straight. Later, mates. Now look out back the way.
Yeah, so how do we decide which reef we go out to?
So every day the captain will decide based on the weather conditions, what's happening on the boat on the day as well. So we're super lucky because we've got something like 28 different dive locations across, I think it's 8 different reefs. So, you know, on good weather days like today, you pick some fantastic days for that. On days where it's perfect and calm, we can get out to the eastern reef. That second boat we went to, for example, we can only go to on good weather because there's no protection from the wind. So even mooring off the boat could be a challenge.
What's the craziest thing you can't get this on the trip or on the reef, on the boat? Really bad weather. Talk about really bad weather.
We've had some really bad weather. Like, I've been up on the bow in the past and it's been blowing gusted 40 knots, so that's 80 kilometers an hour. And you're there and I've been like two jackets all tied in and it's pouring with rain. Really bad. You can't.
The best day was when we got all the way to the reef.
Yeah.
Couldn't find the reef and came back home again.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah.